Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I'm starting a new series, A Git Knowledge for DevOps Engineer. This is the first video in this series. In this video, we are going to use Git init, Git add and Git commit. We are taking a sample project for this series and we are developing this project over the series. Let's begin. The first command is git init. You can add existing project or create a new folder. In this demonstration, I have an empty project. Let me add this project into git version control. So we are going to issue the command. Basically, this command will add car project into version control system. It also create a hidden folder .git. This folder has couple of files and folder and these are used to maintain version control of this folder. Let's create first page in this project. This is going to be a home page of this project. CSS and fonts for this project. Let's open this project into the browser. This is the home page of my project. We just created couple of the files in the project and Git by default don't include any file in version control. Let's check out the current status of the project. You can see a bunch of the information there. You are on master branch. No commits yet. There are untracked file. It means that Git is tracking or monitoring the files and folder, but these files are not added into Git yet. Before enabled or commit these files into Git, you require to add these file into the staging area. Staging area is an area where Git store all the files and folder before moving into commit stage. It means that Git is giving you option to untrack the file or delete the file before committing. You can add individual file . You can add all the file at once. This dot will add all the files into the staging area. If you now do a status check, then you can see these file successfully added into the staging area and ready to commit. Use git commit command add meaningful message to this commit. This message or description will really helpful when we are looking at history or rollback a particular commit. Go ahead and commit it. We successfully commit all the files into Git. Our master branch is clean. Let's add couple of the files in our project. We updated our home page with buy car, sell car and lease car. Let's commit this change. we successfully commit the updated home page. Let's create the buy, sell and lease car page. I have created 3 more pages into the project. Buy a car, sell a car and lease a car. Let's go ahead and commit this change in Git. Now let's go ahead and commit this changes into Git. We successfully commit all the files into Git database. You can get a list of your commit or get a commit history. We can see here we have 3 commits in our project and we are here on this commit, or I can say that this is my latest commit. In this video, that's all. In next video, we are going to revert back some changes from the history in our project. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.